In this video, we'll be talking about permission settings on KNIME Server. In general, KNIME Server is a place to share workflows, data, and other items. But sometimes you don't want other users to execute, overwrite, or even see your workflow. You can set permissions to handle the availability of your workflow to other users. Permissions, also called access rights, access control, access management, or user management in other tools, can be set for all types of items stored on the server, not just workflows. This means workflows, workflow groups, components, and files. Permissions can also be assigned to individual people or to different user groups. User groups are defined by the server administrators who have admin rights. For example, one user group for each department or research team. There is one special predefined group which has admin rights. In addition, admin rights can be given to any user or group. Users with admin rights have no restrictions on permissions. This means they can always execute all workflows, see and overwrite all items, and delete all jobs and items. If you deploy a new item to the server, for example a workflow, you automatically become its owner. The owner, plus everyone with admin rights, can assign and change permissions for that item on the server. Users with admin rights also have the ability to change the owner. There are three permission types for each item: read, write, and execute. Let's focus on workflows first. A user with the permission to read a workflow can download the workflow to his local desktop, including all the data stored in the workflow. But the user is not allowed to execute the workflow on the server, unless, of course, the user has been assigned the respective execute permissions as well. In addition, a user can make his own copy of the workflow and execute it afterwards. With write permissions, the user can modify, delete, and create snapshots of a workflow. A user with permission to execute can execute a workflow that already exists on the server. This means the user can create a workflow job, but the user is not allowed to download that job or store the job after the job has finished, unless the user has, in addition, also read permission. Workflow groups. The read permissions for workflow groups control whether users see the content of the workflow group. This means whether users can see all of the subgroups and other items in the selected workflow group in the KNIME Explorer. If a user has write permissions for a workflow group, the user can create new items in this group, these being subgroups, workflows, data files, and components. Users with read permissions for a data file can execute workflows that use the respective data file and download it to their local desktop. Read permissions for a component allow the user to use the component in a new workflow and download it to their local desktop. Write permissions for data files and components enable the user to overwrite them on the server. Let's now see how permissions can be assigned in KNIME Analytics Platform based on the example of setting permissions for a workflow. You can then use this same procedure to set permissions for other types of items. To set permissions, you have to right-click the item in the KNIME Explorer and select Permissions. The default settings are inherited from the closest parent folder for which permissions have been set manually and are not inherited. If the checkbox Inherit Permissions from Parent is activated and the workflow is moved to a new location, it automatically inherits the permissions of the new parent. This feature is useful if you have development and production folders and you want items to become visible to end users when they are moved into the production folder without needing to change permissions individually for all these items. To change permissions for an item, you have to uncheck the checkbox. You now have the option to set the read, write, and execute permissions for the owner, for user groups and single persons and the world by activating and deactivating the respective checkmarks. The world being all users. By clicking the Edit Rights button, you can change existing and set new permissions for groups and individual users. In the new window, you see that at the moment, members of the group called KNIME can execute the workflow, but aren't allowed to read or overwrite. This is shown by the green tick and the lock icon. Clicking the icon changes the permissions for the group. Assign permissions to an additional group by clicking the plus icon. The second tab allows you to define permissions for single users in the same way. Access rights are cumulative. This means as soon as the permissions for either a group, a single user, or the world allow a user to execute a workflow, he is allowed to do so. A deny in either of these won't override an allow. I hope we've given you a clear overview of the different types of permissions on KNIME Server and how they can be defined for different items, groups, and individual persons.